To learn about sun science and solar safety, we have beads that are sensitive to ultraviolet light. So when that light from the sun hits them, they will turn colors. And we're going to be having people put sunscreen on them or put them in water or put them underneath cloth to see, well, what really protects my skin? Put them behind sunglasses. What protects my eyes when the sun is shining? So for people who like art, we have a flip book. And people can color in their moon stickers and have them watch the path of the moon go across the sun. Yeah, this is a good way for people to see what's happening over the course of that 2.5 hours, but they can just flip through it in a few seconds. A colander is really a set of pinhole projectors. So when the sun's light goes through these holes, it focuses them. And you can see here, just with regular light, it is a circle. But when the sun is shining as a crescent, you will see all of these little crescents. So you can use a colander to project the sun. Now, always do this with your back to the sun. Do not look through the holes at the sun. When the moon is covering the sun's light will only be visible as a crescent. So that light going through those holes will end up as crescent patterns on this paper. You can punch a hole in any piece of paper. We have these available for download on our website, and the same thing will happen. You can focus that crescent sun onto the paper. Eclipses help us learn about the sun, about our environment, so we also have some planetarium shows about the sun that people can watch. We're also going to be showing a live stream of the total eclipse, so since we don't have it here, inside we'll have some websites going so people can watch how the total eclipse looks at other places in the U.S. So a solar eclipse is all about, a solar eclipse is all about the geometry of the Earth, the Moon, and the Sun. So we have models of the sun and the moon, and would you like to be one of them?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, you can be the moon. Okay. And so the moon is going to go right in front of the sun, and everyone watching right now is the Earth. So you see the moon blocking the sun. This happens when the moon is at a new moon phase. Mm-hmm. Now, usually when we have a new moon, the moon is a little bit above the sun in the sky, or so you can move it up. So the shadow does not fall on, usually during a new moon, the moon is a little bit above or below the sun in the sky so that the moon does not block the sun. But a couple of times a year, the moon is directly between the sun and Earth.
Gotcha.
And it blocks out the sun. The moon and the sun are exactly the same size in our sky, and that's just by coincidence. So that's why the moon can completely cover the sun.
Which, by, you know, people at home are going to see this and they're going to go, oh, well, I see the shadow and it's not covering up the entirety of the sun. The sun is bigger, obviously, than the moon, but when it comes to Earth and it looks like that, they kind of line it together.
The sun is 400 times bigger than the moon, but also 400 times farther away. So that's why they have that same size in the sky.